Despite violent retaliation to Confederate monuments here in North Carolina, the figures still stand around the South. WAY's Kylie Jones sat down with one man who was determined to learn who is keeping them alive. So Kylie, what did you find out?
Randy, the presence of Confederate statues runs deep, even in Wilmington. Investigative journalist Shauna Sale shared with me that the monuments are backed by one particular group that may be quiet, but they are mighty.
Confederate monuments have turned into tribal dog whistles.
Shauna Sale says the monuments throughout the South have driven a wedge between the nation that is wider than ever.
Seeing the shouting matches that were going on in front of these monuments. And the groups are divided into two camps. They're called hate versus heritage. At least that's what the bumper sticker slogan is.
That led Sale to dig deeper to uncover what the supporters really stood for, which resulted in his recent article in Glamour magazine, The Secret Fight to Save Confederate Monuments. What he found...
in building the narrative of the Civil War not being about slavery, about being about states' rights, about secession, about all the things that matter today. And that's why I think it's a fight over political power and not over the meaning of slavery.
As Sale spoke with the United Daughters of Confederacy, he discovered the group is very much alive and has a lot of soft power. Their belief, these monuments signify their history and ancestors who lost their lives. But to the opposition...
they find it offensive. You know, they find these statues as constant reminders of a time where they were disenfranchised, where horrible things happened.
Sale says political power has fueled the fight. Ultimately, he sees one solution.
Contextualization about adding language, not necessarily toppling history, but adding to history with more speech.
Sale thinks there can be a happy medium, but the divide between groups is just so powerful. We did reach out to the United Daughters of the Confederacy and the Sons of Confederate Veterans for comment, but they did not respond. You can find a link, though, to Sale's article on our website. Randy?
Thank you very much, Kylie.